Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be building a Facebook bot which will automatically post to your Facebook profile inside Puppeteer and Node.js. Let me just launch the application and show to you how this application looks. So basically it will now launch a window automatically. This is a Chromium window and it will go to facebook.com and automatically write my credentials inside email and password, and then it will click the login button. So it is done automatically. So now the bot will wait for a few seconds for the page to load up correctly, and here you will see a black window which will appear, the bot will automatically click on this black window and then it will go to my profile page. So this is a nice thing about Puppeteer, all the things happens automatically. So you can see that it has gone to my profile page, and now once again it will click the black window which will appear. After it will write two posts automatically. So you can see that it is clicking on the black window once again, and now it will write this post. So it will post this post here, and now it will post the second post with a slight delay. So this will be a longer post, so you can see the typing speed as well. So this is a bot speed, you can say. So this is a Puppeteer library. So this will be the application that we will be building. So this is a long post that we are writing. So now it will click the post button once again, and now you will see my post has been posted. Two posts have been posted. So this will be the application that we will be building. So let's start building this application. So here inside my package.json, I have installed two dependency. First is .env and Puppeteer. So you can install these dependency, and also I have installed NodeMon, so which will restart the server automatically when we make any kind of changes. So all the source code of this application is given in the video description, guys. So this is my step-by-step blog that I have written here. All the source code is given with instructions, and at the bottom of the page of my blog you can see the download link to the source code. So you can go to my GitHub repository, click on this code button and download the zip file to follow along with the video. Now I will write the code here inside my this is my file here, you can see app.js. So inside your package.json, after you install all these dependencies, change this index.js to app.js, and then inside the script section make a new start script and write here nodemon app.js. And now inside app.js we will import Puppeteer. So we will write const Puppeteer, and we need to require it. So require Puppeteer. So after this, guys, we will have an async function which we will write. Just put semicolons here, semicolon, it is very much important. And now we will have an async function here. So this will be an arrow function. So now to invoke this function automatically, we will put a set of parentheses. So now if I write anything here, it will, let's suppose, a console log message, hello world. So now if I want to execute it, so let me just go to my command line. So here if I write npm start, you will see the console log message which will come in hello world, you can see that. So now what we want here is that we need to initialize the Puppeteer window to open facebook.com. So this is pretty easy. We need to have try catch block here, so if any kind of error take place, we can console log the error. So inside this try block, guys, we will be instantiating a new instance of Puppeteer. So make a browser variable, and we will be awaiting the response because we are in async function. So we will use Puppeteer dot the launch function. So this expects some parameters to be passed. First parameter is headless, so this will initialize to false, and the second parameter is slow motion. So you have to have some slow motion to your bot. I will provide this value to 20. So you can change these values accordingly, and then we will initialize a page variable. We will await the response, which is a browser dot new page. So this is a function So we will initialize a new page. Now we will be invoking another method, await page. So let me just restart my, stop my server here, because it will, obviously it will run it. This is NodeMonf, so we need to stop it. So you can see that await page, we need to go to a specific address. So here we will pass the address, that is facebook.com. And then facebook.com, now let me just start my server and show to you npm start. So you will see a Chromium window will launch and automatically, so which will point to the address facebook.com that we have entered. So it will go to facebook.com, you can see that. And now to enter the email address and password of my account, it is pretty easy. Let me close this window and also just restart my server. So here we need to provide some other parameters. We need to set the viewport as well. So we need to give it a fixed width and height. For that we need to again have another function, page.setViewport. So this is a function guide, setViewport, and inside this we can pass the width to, let's suppose, 1000 pixels and the height to, let's suppose, 600 pixels. After setting the width and the height of the window, I think this statement should come before go to statement. So just paste this statement before that, like this. So also we need to prevent the timeout also. So just after you initialize your page, we need to write this line, page.setDefaultNavigationTimeout. So here you need to provide a very big value. So let's suppose I provide this value to be, let's suppose, 1. You can say this value is second, so 0000000. So set default navigation timeout. So this line is very much necessary. So after, we need to grab the email and password fields. So for that, guys, we need to invoke another function, which will be page.waitForSelector. So this is our method, waitForSelector. And here we will target it by the ID. So I have personally gone to the Facebook website and I have grabbed these values for the email field. So we will be targeting it by the ID, which is email. And then we will automatically type by this method, which is page.type. So this will be my Facebook email address. So we will type it for the email. So first of all, we will pass the ID and then the value. So the value will be simply my email address, which is kauti12345@mail.com. And this is the email address done. And now we will type the password. So page.type. So the password. So we will be first of all be giving the selector, which is pass here for the password field, and then we need to pass the password. So a nice thing that I want to tell you inside this tutorial, you need not have to expose your password because in real life applications. So here we will be making a env file, .env file, and inside this you will store your password. Let's suppose I declare abv password, and here my password is test123. This is a password. So don't ever use this password. After the video, I will change my password. So this is the password now. Now we need to get this password inside the app.js file. So right here at the top, you will write a simple line, which will be require. We need to require this .env module. And then we will be invoking a method .config. That's it. And now we will get the value by process.env. process.env dot your Facebook password. So this was a variable that I declared. That's it. So after getting the password, guys, we need to click on the login button. So this is pretty simple also. We will await the response once again. Now we will click page.click, and inside this we need to pass the selector here. So we will use a backtick symbol, and this time the type will be equal to submit. So type will be equal to submit. So this is a selector. We will automatically click on that. So now let me just see if it is working properly or not. So if I execute the script, so you will see, hopefully see, it will redirect to facebook.com, and now it will type the password and the email address automatically. So it is going to Facebook. So now it is typing the email and password and clicking on the login button. So let me just see if it is. So it is saying to the no node found for selector. So let me just see, guys, what is the problem. So let me just terminate my script. So here, await page dot click. So type submit. Let me just go to my script, guys. So really quickly, because this can happen with anyone. Because you can see that this is the code here. Await page dot click. Let me just copy this. So on the new line, let me just see the difference here. Type is equal to submit. Oh, I think I have missing the semicolon. That my mistake here. After this, let me just rerun the application once again. npm start. So just wait. It is starting once again. And now it is clicking the button also, so you can see that. So now we need to prevent this black window. So you will see a black window which will appear here, right here. We need to click on that black window automatically when once we land on this page. For that to happen, we need to do two things. First, let me just stop the server. After this, guys, you just need to first of all wait for the page to load. So for that there is a method which is page dot wait for navigation. So you need to call this method. So basically it will wait for the page to properly load, and then we will be clicking on the page dot click, and here we will pass the div. Just pass the div, so it will click on that black window which will appear. So after clicking on that black div, we need to wait for 5 seconds. So now for waiting, we can use the wait for method. So there is a wait for method which is there. Wait for. And here we can pass millisecond. Let's suppose I pass 5000 milliseconds. So this means wait for 5 seconds. And after waiting for 5 seconds, we need to redirect the user to my profile, which is let me use the goto method once again, and this is a profile of mine. So you can just change the URL to your profile, facebook.com geekygotham1997. And now let me see if it is working or not. So you can divide this application into small chunks and then test if each chunk is going well. So that is, I am testing application on every front. So now you will see it will type the email and password, click login, and automatically my Facebook will be redirected to my profile page. So it will first of all look for a black window to appear, and then it will click on that window. So just wait. You can see the black window. So it will click this black window and then wait for 4 seconds, and then it will redirect to my profile page. So you can see it is redirecting it to my profile page. Now we just need to post the two posts out there, post the two sentences inside this field. That's pretty easy, guys. Let me just close this once again. Let me stop the server. And once again, we need to click the black window which will appear once we go to my profile page. For that, it is pretty simple. After this step, we again want to wait. Page, wait for. We need to wait for 3 seconds. So here I will pass 3000 milliseconds. After this, guys, we need to again click that page.click. Click div. We need to click that black div. After clicking this, we need to click on the input field where we will be writing our post. So this will be page, wait for selector. And here we need to pass the selector here, guys. So the selector will be pretty simple here. So this will be constant for you also. So inside you will write in backtick symbol. And this selector is area dot label. So area label will be equal to what's on your mind. Question mark, and then you need to close this brackets. That's it. I put a semicolon as well. So now it will also, we need to first of all wait for the selector, and then we need to click this selector also. So paste dot click, and we need to copy paste the same lines that we have written here. So I can just paste this selector once again. Paste this selector like this. So now it will click the selector, and now we need to embed our sentences. So let me just see if it is working or not before proceeding, because I need to test everything. So now it will go to my Facebook, type the email password, login. So it will wait for some time to page to load, and then it will click the black window like this. And then wait for 4 seconds, and then it will redirect to the profile page. And now it will once again click the black window, which will appear. The black window will every time appear when you go to a page in Facebook. So again, it will click this black window. Wait for some time, and then it will click this window of input. Now here we need to input our post here. So this post can be anything. You can, let's suppose you want to promote your blog links. You can put this links as well. So I will be just be writing text post. For now, you can play with this application as you want. I will be declaring a sentence list array. So this will be an array. So the first line will be, let's suppose my name is Gautam and I am 23 years of old, programmer, YouTuber, blogger. The second line, let's suppose I am a software developer from India, and this is my dream to code. So now we have defined these two sentences. Now we need to post them automatically on my profile. So just put semicolon, don't forget, and then we will use a for loop. So let j is equal to 0, j less than sentence list dot length J plus plus. Inside this outer loop, we will go to the inner loop for each sentence. So we will get the individual sentence here like this, let sentence, and then we will sentence, we can use sentence list here, the current iteration to get the current sentence. After getting the current sentence, we will use the inner loop, which will be int, sorry, let j, let I is equal to 0, I less than sentence dot length I plus plus, And inside this, guys, we need to, after getting the length here, we need to press the keyboard. So we can say here await page dot keyboard dot press. So we will press these keys here accordingly what is written here. So we will pass here sentence I, that's it. So after writing all the text here, we will first of all check if it is a last sentence, if it is a last line by writing this. So if I is equal to triple equal to sentence length minus 1. So basically it tells that it is the last word. So if it is the last word, then we need to click on the post button. In order to click the post button, we need to first of all wait for some time. We need to wait for, let's suppose, wait for 2 seconds. So we will pass here 2 milliseconds. After waiting 2 milliseconds, we will press the control button. So page dot keyboard dot press. And we will press the control button. So here we will pass control. So if you haven't used the shortcut in Facebook, if you press control and enter, the post will be automatically posted. So here I am just replicating this effect in Puppeteer. So then we need to press this enter key. So in order to press, we will again, in order to this time. So this needs to be, guys, down. So the control key has to be pressed all the time. So this needs to be down, and now we need to press the enter key. So in order to press the enter key, there is a constant which is string dot from character code, and there is a character code for the enter key which is 13. So now if you pass this, the enter key will be automatically pressed. After this, we also need to write this line, which is page dot keyboard up. We also need to up the key of the control key which we have pressed in the earlier step. After this, guys, you need to wait for 4 seconds for typing the other sentence. So page wait, again we will wait for 4 seconds before writing the next line, because Facebook will block us if we spam. So this application is not for spammers, I need to tell. This is just for educational purpose. So we can also console log it that done message. And again, this line is pretty important. We need to again click the selector once again in order to write the next line. So this will be backtick symbol. And here we can just write our selector. We can copy the selector. You can see this is a selector. So paste the selector, that's it. So now this completes the application, guys. So what we need to do, we need to start our application, and hopefully it will, if I npm start, it will start the application. Now it will go to facebook.com and it will enter the email address, password, click the login button, and now it will wait for some time, click the black window. So it will click the black window once the page loads, you can see. So it will click the black window, it will now proceed to my profile page, which is Geeky Gotham 1997. And now it will once again click the black window once the page loads. And now it will hit this input field, and here we will write our text here. What is the error here? I is not defined. Yeah. Oh, I is not defined. Where it is, I is not defined. Where in the application? 54 line. Oh, so, sorry guys, this needs to be J. This is my mistake here. This was the silliest mistake that I have done here, you can see. So if you code here, you can bound to make mistakes. So don't feel that you are the perfect programmer in the world. Every programmer makes a mistake. So don't feel angry. So now it will click the black window. So after clicking the black window, it will redirect to my profile page. And now it will write these two posts. First of all, it will click the black window once again. So you can see that my name is Gautam. Click the post button. So this post will be posted, and now it will hit the second post for I am a software developer from India and this is my dream to code. And then it will again post it. So these two posters have been posted. You can see that. And if you don't believe it, I real time I can go to my Facebook account. So this is my Facebook account, and here if I go to my profile, you will find out this. I have written these posts, right? You can see that automatically with this bot here. You can see this is my profile, which is you can see. So this was the application, guys. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please the like button and also subscribe the channel, and I will be seeing you in the next video.